Hey guys, so I made a lot of videos on Real Racing 3 already because, well, I play that game a lot. I spent so many hours on it. I've actually enjoyed a lot of hours on it, although after a certain point, it kind of felt like I was playing because I was addicted, not because I was really enjoying it. Because I think at certain points, a lot of games do kind of pull us into that. I think many times when we play games like Call of Duty, we get into the multiplayer experience because we're kind of hooked. You know, the experience of doing that anymore, it's not like the full enjoyment of it, but we're kind of suckered into it. We're like, oh, gotta keep unlocking that. I gotta keep buying that. Build experience on that. Earn money on that. So I feel like that's how I got suckered into Real Racing 3 at a certain point. But amazing game. And I actually look really forward to Real Racing 4 whenever that comes out. I kind of worry about the pricing structure of it. I wonder if it's still, if it's again going to be a free-to-play game with ridiculous pricing structure. Wouldn't mind a free-to-play game again, actually, as long as it had a more sensible pricing structure. And like I said, Real Racing 3 has a pretty sensible pricing structure when you're considering the lower tier series, the lower tier of cars and races. It's only when you get to the higher tiers, the supercars, that the pricing structure becomes ridiculous. And the expectations of earning money without spending real money is ridiculous. But beyond that, I would be really excited for Real Racing 4 for one thing. If they improved upon one thing, I think that one thing would just get me just suckered and addicted into the whole Real Racing thing once again. And that really has to do with the AI. This whole time-shifted multiplayer concept, I think, is crazy innovative and crazy awesome. The fact that I'm actually driving against other human players' time, even though it's an AI-controlled car, it's a great concept. The only thing is, they're still AI-driven cars, and they still feel like it. They still don't react to you. Don't react to me when I'm driving past them or driving behind them. They drive exactly the same way as they would if I'm not there or if I'm there, if I'm trying to corner them or not. For example, the one most frustrating thing about Real Racing 3 is when I'm turning a corner and there's the AI car here and I'm doing this corner and it's like I have to get past him in this way, and all of a sudden the car like just goes here. I mean, like, it's in a set path. And no matter what I do, like, the AI is programmed to drive this specific route. And it does that, regardless of what the surrounding situation is. And that kind of just breaks the immersion of the game. And that's definitely not how a human player would race. They don't drive any better, and they don't drive any worse when I'm here or when I'm not there. There's no dynamic racing. So even though I'm racing against other people's times, if I'm able to exploit the routes that they, because at certain points in the game, my car was really horrible. Like, I didn't have any money to do any upgrades, but I was still winning the races because I was exploiting the fact that, like, in a straight line, the computer driven cars would just go faster and faster and faster because they're better cars. And then we come to a corner. I know exactly, because I play the game so much, I know exactly how that computer-driven car is going to handle that corner. He's going to brake at this spot, and then he's going to come here, slide a little bit, and then turn this way using this corner. Because I know that, I accelerate a little bit faster than him before he brakes, and then I brake just slightly after he brakes, and I kind of gradually go into this corner here, and then I sharp turn here, and then just accelerate that way. Doing that every time, even with a worse car, I win. I overtake. And at certain point, it's just less challenging. So it becomes too easy. But on certain courses, like the Melbourne course, the Australia course, where you're practically playing bumper cars because the rules are so narrow, the computer is so inconsiderate of your existence. It doesn't know you exist at all. It just drives the way it does. Because of that, it's hard to win. Because it's extremely hard to exploit that you know, the cornering that the computer does. I know that the computer is going to turn the corner that way, but that's what I need to do as well. So, like, it's hard to exploit it, and there's no way to, like, you know, really interact with the AI-driven cars. So, my whole point is, Real Racing 4, if it is ever developed and comes out, and I'm pretty sure it will, because Real Racing 3 was pretty successful. If it does, like, I hope AI is better. I hope, like, it actually interacts with you and is more dynamic. This whole concept of time shifted multiplayer, playing against other human players, I think is great. I think what would be really cool is if it also recorded how human players raced, and their behavior is recorded, and that's how the computer player drives. That would be pretty cool. And I know Forza is kind of doing Forza 5, but I don't know if the technology is going to be enough for a game on the iPad or the iPhone. Maybe on the newer phones, like the iPhone 5S, which was recently announced, or the Android phones like Galaxy Nexus 4, something like that. Like the high-tech phones were, you know, high technology. I suppose they could start doing things where the game records the behaviors of human players and takes that behaviors and integrates it into AI-driven cars. And so AI-driven cars have a more human personality to it. That would be amazing. Just bettering the AI of Real Racing would make this game so much better. Because at this point, the AI of Real Racing 3 is no better than the AI of Gran Turismo 3. I think even Gran Turismo 4 had better AI than Real Racing 3. And that's a shame, because on the phone, like, it's such an amazing game, but it's so hindered by a static AI. So if they can fix that, then if they make it so much better, then put me on board for Real Racing 4.